Thanks, Nick.
Did you see what that was?
You didn't see what you just hit?
Would I be asking if I did?
Nick, how could you not see it?
I was looking at you.
You know, I think that's why they recommend keeping your eyes on the road when you're driving. Apparently, it's supposed to help.
What was it? Because I can't see it.
How should I know?
How should you know? You weren't watching the road?
I'm not driving. Is that it? To the right.
Yeah, that's it.
Oh my God. I think we need to head back to town then.
Did you get a hold of anyone?
No, there's no reception out here.
Yeah, give me your phone.
Nick, it's useless. There's no bars out here.
I think I took off his head. I tried to look for it.
What?
I must have hit him so hard.
You looked for it?
I tried.
I'm sorry. Let's just head back now and get help. It was an accident. We need to go see.
Ah, happy to see some brave souls here today. Very nice. Hope you're planning on an interesting day today, because today we will be examining a dead body. Known as a cadaver to us, you know, official types. And I hope you all heeded my advice against eating the cafeteria burritos this morning. I have a feeling some of this will not sit well with some of you. Today we'll be examining Mr. Breckard. Mr. Breckard has so graciously volunteered himself to the university's Wheeled Potty program. And just to let you all know, I stole him for you. You'll be the first class to be able to examine a real cadaver. After this, he'll be shipped off, and the next class will have to deal with fake body parts.
Dude, don't you have a whole fridge full of these things?
Oh, no. If only. No, we do not have these things stocked up. Got to hide this guy. Got to take him off the list, put him in the back, all for you. Now, to further answer your question, however, yes, this area lacks in donor support. There's not much enthusiasm from the board of directors to support such a program.
What do you mean?
Oh, this college apparently isn't sought out enough to afford a volunteer program, unlike the other larger universities. Meaning, fewer bodies in the fridge. But if you would like to volunteer, I'd be more than happy to help you fill out some paperwork back at my office.
Yeah, thanks. But I don't plan on being dead anytime soon.
Probably true, but you can never be too prepared.
You do know what you're doing, don't you, Steph? Because you're only hurting yourself. You need to think about that and what you want.
Well, I know what I want. I told you that. I want...
Yeah, I know. You want Nick to come around and see what he's been missing out on. But I gotta tell you something. Us dudes, we don't know what we're doing.
I thought that's what you guys said about us.
Yeah, I guess we do, but it does go both ways. We just can't say that.
Uh-huh.
I'm serious, though. You need to evaluate your situation and make a decision.
I'm gonna make a decision on this drive.
So you're gonna tell him? That it's over?
I don't want it to be over.
How long have you been initiating everything? Yeah, since the beginning. And I don't think things are gonna change.
It's just his nervousness. Once he can get past that, we could have an awesome relationship.
Oh my God, you're in college. What's this whole, I want to get married and have kids look?
All girls want to get married and have their prince charming.
Not all girls. But that's not what I'm saying. Look, maybe Nick isn't the right one for you. Maybe there's someone out there that'll treat you right.
Yeah, you're talking about all those fish in the sea.
Yeah, I am. And you know what? There's a fish out there that's searching for you. And is willing to make the sacrifice of jumping out of the water.
Oh, Danny, that was cute.
I'm not kidding with you. Here I am giving you support when you need it, and I just get teased. You know what? Whatever.
Yeah, right. Come on. Danny the teddy bear.
You just tease me. That's all you do.
Stop it. I'm messing with you. And I do just tease you.
Yeah, you do.
Anyway, fish in the sea.
Look, Nick's not gonna change. People don't do that so well.
He did, though. And that's the problem.
Look, just do it on the drive, and I promise you won't regret it. You have to think about the long run.
Hey, guys.
What's up, man?
You about to head to class?
Nah, not quite yet.
We have a little bit of time. How was your test?
It was good, actually. I think I passed, which is a good thing. Because this test make up the entire grade for the class.
That's awesome. Nick, good job.
Yeah, man. Good job.
Thanks. Okay, guys. Steph, I'm gonna call you later. Danny.
Peace.
All right, Danny, I'll call you when we get back.
Why don't you call me on the drive?
Because. Bye.
You knock first before entering. Thank you. So, Travis, how's it going?
I'm good.
Good. You know why I called you in here?
No.
Take a guess, Travis. You're a smart guy.
Why don't you give me a hint?
Why don't you tell me the reason you're in my class?
At the moment, actually, I think I'm in your office, and you're about to explain why.
And I think humor is not your best bet right now if you want me not to cut you.
Humor?
Tell me, what do you plan on pursuing after school? I think it's going to be in the field of medicine. And I got to tell you right now, it's going to take a lot of time, and a lot of determination. I know you have it in you to succeed. Hell, I've graded your papers. But if there's going to be one thing that's going to hold you back from that goal, it's going to be about your attitude.
I don't think I have an attitude, Jim.
There's a difference of opinion now, isn't there? Okay, I'm gonna go back to the reason why I brought you in here.
You asked me in here because I was taking pictures of your cadaver.
Yeah, that and my work. This is a structured class with rules. What you do on your own time does not follow you on the campus. Yeah. What about the pictures?
I use them as reference.
For what?
The work that I'm doing?
We are talking about homework, right?
Yeah.
Seems a bit extreme for homework, don't you think? I mean, there are pictures and diagrams in the text. All right. Listen, from here on out, you abide by the rules of the syllabus and you abide by the rules that I place on the table. I don't want to hold you back, but there are certain limitations to the amount of research you're conducting. Are we clear about the pictures now?
No more pictures. Sure.
Yeah, sure means you might do it again. I want a different answer.
Of course, Dr. Conklin.
Thank you, Travis. Glad to see you keeping your grades up. It's good. Let's keep it that way, shall we? And please, the next time we have a meeting, could it be something more positive?
Yeah.
okay?
I'm fine, Steph.
Well, you know I don't believe that, but okay.
Believe me or not, that's cool. I'm telling you like it is.
Yeah, and how it is isn't so comfortable.
I know.
So, something's bothering you.
Why did he have his hands in yours?
Danny's a touchy guy. He was talking about something personal.
And he had to have his hands on yours for that?
I guess so. Do you still want me to go with you this weekend?
Of course I want you around. I guess I'm just thinking about the drive home. Not really sure if I'm up to it. Plus, I don't even know why you want to go either.
Look, I offered to go. If you still want the company, I'm there. If not, fine.
You got it.
So?
If you want to go, then go.
Did you remember Tom's having his party tonight?
Yeah.
Are we still going?
Sure.
Well, if you decide you do, just pick me up at 8:30, and we can head there. Then we can leave if you still want me to go with you.
All right.
See you later.
Dude, I don't know if you're aware, we don't actually let wallflowers in here. It's kind of a rule. What's up, man?
Good.
Water. You should upgrade. Drink something that'll make you feel all warm and fuzzy.
Yeah, not tonight.
Yeah, tonight.
Nah, seriously. I'm driving all night.
Oh, that's right. Forgot you were heading home this weekend. Speaking of Steph, where is she?
I don't know.
You don't know? Have you tried looking for her?
Yeah.
So what's going on? You guys dating or what?
I think so.
You think so? Does she think so?
Who knows?
Nick, I'm gonna give you a piece of advice. I know you're not gonna take it, but I'm gonna give it to you anyway. If you don't take that girl, someone else will.
Thanks, Kyle.
Speak of the devil.
Where have you been?
Here.
I was just here a second ago and you weren't here.
I was just wandering around a bit.
Hey, Kyle.
Hey.
Is this for me?
Yeah, that's for you.
Dance with me.
Nah, it's all right.
Come on, I know you got moves. Dance with me.
No, I'm gonna save my energy for the drive home. Go have fun. It's cool.
Okay.
Hey, kids.
What's up, Danny?
Hey.
So, Nick, I'm gonna steal your girl for a sec.
Huh?
I just wanna dance with someone who actually knows how to dance for a change.
Yeah, go for it.
All right, let's go.
There she goes.
If you just listen to me, you would understand.
I've been listening. You're not making any sense.
I'm making perfect sense. You just don't want to hear it.
This is bullshit.
Huh? You won't address it, so I have to.
Fine. Go for it.
You know, we were so close before. I liked that guy. And my feelings just got away from me.
Steph, I agree. You're my best friend.
You agree. Nick, I don't believe you.
Why? I look the same, I feel the same, I really like you. That makes me the same.
I mean, you used to be so kind and confident. Back when we were friends.
You're breaking up with me?
I think we need to take a break.
I want things to work out, Steph. I do. You don't have to say what you're about to say. This is gonna sound corny and overused, but I can change.
Thank you.
You wait here, Steph, okay? I'll do the talking.
Hi.
We were just on the road, and we were driving. I was driving, and there's been an accident.
Are you guys both okay?
Yes, we're fine. But we hit someone near your driveway.
My driveway?
Yeah. This one?
Yeah, that's my driveway. Is he all right?
No, he's not okay. We tried calling out on our cell phones, but we don't get any reception out here. So we were hoping we can use your phone to call the police. Hey. Do you have a phone that we can use?
Yeah, I'm sorry. Did you say he was all right?
No. He's dead.
Oh. Yeah, I do. I'm sorry. Why don't you guys come inside and you can use my phone to call whoever you need to call. If you guys want to take a seat, I will make the call.
Yeah, hi. I've had an accident out on 5322 Canyon Road. My name is Travis. And thankfully an individual was hit by a car. Yes, as I know, the person is not living.
Don't you think I should be calling the cops?
The two that were in the car are now in my living room. They're just waiting. Okay. Yes, they are okay. Yes, they're fine. Okay, thank you. Bye-bye.
They're on their way.
Did they say how long they'd be?
I'd say about an hour or two.
Okay.
You two must be shaking just a bit, huh?
Yeah, just a bit.
Was it you driving?
Yeah.
Well, what happened?
We were having an argument.
Nothing happened. I'm sorry, but we didn't get your name yet.
My name's Travis. I apologize. So, who checked on him?
I did.
Really?
Yeah.
That's no good. Did you look for all of him?
What?
Okay, I hate to bring this up, but have you even considered the possibility of it being one of your neighbors?
No.
Don't you think he needs a call?
Not yet.
I think anyone in the near vicinity needs a call.
Okay.
She has a point. Not your neighbor. It could be somebody that knows him.
Well, that's quite possible.
I think they'd want to know.
Well, I'd want to know.
Exactly.
Tell me something. How did it make you feel when you realized it?
Realized what?
That it was over for him? Something had ended?
I don't know.
You don't? It happened just 10 minutes ago. Are you telling me you don't remember how you felt?
I don't want to talk about it.
And he doesn't have to. Can't we just sit here and wait for the police?
You don't want to talk about it. And it's gonna slip by. Everything slips by. Nick here lets things slip through the fingers, doesn't he?
I don't think that's any of your business.
Sure it is. You see, you two are here now. In my house, after hitting somebody close to my driveway. And I'm just trying to have a chat.
I don't think we're interested in having a chat about our personal lives.
Well, I didn't say it was about your personal life, did I?
Do you have a bathroom I can use?
Yeah. It's this first left down the hall.
Hey, mind if you use your phone? My phone doesn't have any reception.
I'm gonna make a phone call in the other room.
Okay. I'm gonna go make a call after Nick.
Great.
Does that guy seem all right to you?
No.
None of the phones are working.
What?
Phones. They're dead. I don't get it. If none of the phones are working, how did he call the police? Yeah.
I think we should get in the car and leave. Okay, yeah, we're out of here. Okay, why don't we do this?
Are we in a hurry?
Yeah. We're gonna go see if we can get some help further down the road.
But the police are on their way.
It's okay, just tell them we left. We'll take the responsibility.
Responsibility?
Thanks for letting us use your phone. If you want, we can give you a call when the police get a hold of us.
What if I didn't call the police?
We know you didn't call the police.
Good. Can you guess what happens next?
No.
Tell me, sir, what would you do if I came forward and attempted to cover your face with this?
I'd run.
And where would you run? So, obviously, this isn't an option. And I suggest you two stay put.
Thank you.
Put the gun down. I said put the gun down.
Nick, run!
See, now you're just being stupid, Steph.
Go!
That's funny. Do you really think that Nick can run? Nick, do you really think you can run faster? Nick? Excellent. Good hit. Do you play soccer?
No!
You know what? It would be unfair of me to make fun of you for getting beat up by a girl. I mean, I will say, she packs quite the punch. And to demean you would be a contradiction. But what I did find interesting was that your gun was loaded. Now, didn't I say keep the gun empty so as to keep them alive? That's what I remember. You see my reflection? I will empty this clip into your head, unless we both agree that I make the decisions around here. If you ever consider your opinion a valid point again, I will end it for you. That's a promise. So, we need to get back on track and find them. You promised me you would keep this under control if I allowed you to help. Don't fail again, and neither will I. But, take the bullets from your gun, or I will bury you out here with the rest. Okay?
You okay?
Yeah, are you?
Yeah.
Steph, I tried to help. I wanted...
Nick, it's okay. You did what I told you to.
I know, but I need you to know that I didn't leave you. Steph, I'm serious. When I saw that you ran off, I knew I was gonna find you again. Those are files. I was just about to take a look at one.
It's Dr. Conklin. This is from our anatomy class. I think Travis planned for us to hit that body. Hello?
Hey, babe, what's going on? You guys still driving?
Danny?
Yeah, what's up?
Oh, my God, Danny, we need your help, fast.
Oh, what's going on? You guys okay?
Danny, we haven't made it to where we're going. We're stuck at some house. Please, call the police. We're at 5322 Canyon Road.
Babe, you're totally breaking up on me. Alright, so 5322 Canyon Road, is that what you're saying? Steph, what's going on?
Do you think he understood?
I don't know, we'll have to see.
I think we should go check out his neighbor's house. You might have a phone there that works.
Nick, why don't you stop talking and let me work this out?
What was with that?
I don't know, man. She broke up.
Broke up with him or with you?
Come on. They're like stuck on the side of the road or something.
She probably wants you to help her out, huh?
Yeah, man. She was like... freaking out, too. It's crazy.
Yeah, could get you closer to getting laid, though.
Yeah, man. Screw that. They're like an hour and a half drive from here. Besides, that kid Nick, he's got no clue what he's doing. It's like he's in love with her or something.
That's cool. But think how much action you'll actually get for going all the way out there, though.
Yeah, dude, screw that. I already got it in the bag. And maybe Nick will learn that working on a woman is kind of like working on a car. And he can't do it.
Sweet metaphor, dude.
Dude, you have no idea. Today, I was feeding this line about fish in the sea and all this bullshit came out. She just ate it all up. It was so good.
Well, dude, if I were you, I'd do it. I'd go out there.
No, you wouldn't.
You're right, I wouldn't.
Thank you.
Give me your gun.
What do you need?
We need to use a phone.
There's a payphone. It's right over there.
But there's a guy. Can we just use the phone inside?
Told you, we're closed.
Please, can we just use the phone inside?
The phone is not working.
Oh, yeah. That's right. I forgot. All right. Come on in. I don't usually let people in past closing time. But I guess at first glance, looks like you two are in need of some help. All right, what happened? Your car break down, you run out of gas. You young folks these days, you just don't take care of yourselves the way you should. As I was saying, I don't have a problem helping you two. You look like pleasant individuals. I'm Cindy.
Steph. This is Nick.
So, you said you needed a phone?
Yeah.
Who do you want me to dial?
Is it right if I use it?
You tell me who to dial, and I'll dial them.
Lady, it'd be best if I use the phone. Could I please use the one in your hand?
I try to be hospitable, and you throw it right back in my face with rudeness. You're all the same. One, I don't like your attitude. And two, it doesn't reach.
Miss? I apologize. We need to get a hold of the police. Someone's chasing us.
Who?
I don't know. He said his name was Travis. He didn't give us a last name.
Travis? I don't know of any Travis around here. How old is he?
About our age.
Oh. Well, that's why. We've got just a bunch of reserved quiet types out here. No young ones like you two enjoy the sticks. And we all like it that way.
Oh, okay. Could you call the police for us and let them know where we are? We'd really appreciate it.
Okay. Take lessons from your girlfriend on manners. That's strange. Let me check the one in the back. I have problems with this one sometimes.
Why is that in your pocket?
I was gonna kiss you on the drive last night. I wanted extra fresh and minty breath.
That'd be a first.
No. I always want fresh and minty breath.
You have really bad timing.
Yeah, well, yours isn't that great either.
I tried so many times to jumpstart this relationship. You sat there and did nothing.
Nothing?
I brought fresh breath.
Listen, I guess since it's over anyways, I'll say this now. Steph, there's been this intimidation level that's been plaguing me ever since we first started dating. I mean, yeah, we were friends like no other, but when it came time for me to step up to the plate and bat, threw this curveball that scared the hell out of me. Everything just spiraled down with insecurities and failures. When we leave this place, we're gonna go back to who we were a while ago. Friends that cared about each other and enjoyed the company.
I didn't know you liked baseball.
Thank you.
Steph. Are you okay? Wait. If you stay right here, no one's gonna see you. I'm just gonna go around the corner and see what's over there.
No.
It's okay. Just promise me you're gonna stay right here.
No.
Steph. No one's gonna see you. It's dark. If anyone comes through this door right here, they're not even just gonna walk.
Let me go with you.
You can't, okay? I'll be right back. It's gonna be okay. Just promise me you're not gonna come after me. Please stay right here. Can you do that? You can do this. It's gonna be okay. Stay right here.
Get down. Thank you.
Nick, I'm gonna let you know, buddy, we don't need you anymore. See, we have Steph, and it would have been nice to have two specimens to work with, but with the trouble you've been causing us, I'm gonna say she'll do just fine. Oh, she's going to make us a wonderful amount of money. As a matter of fact, I should thank you for bringing me such a beautiful canvas to work with. Parts like hers don't go cheap. And neither would have yours, you know, but given the fact that you won't kindly put that shotgun down, I'm gonna have to bury you out here.
Trusted him. I understand. How do we make it look that way? Okay. So what do we do with him?
Step.
Okay. I know I've been over this with you so many times already, but...
Yeah, I know. You talked to me 3 times, Smith twice. Same questions you keep asking still got the same answers. We're looking into all this. Travis? Yeah, we investigated the house. No bullet holes, no missing people or vehicles. We're looking into all this. That's what we do, not you.
Yeah, but it just doesn't seem like you have. I mean, I'm sorry. I'm gonna be honest. I came in here to see if you have anything new.
Well, see, that's your first problem. We'll contact you, not the other way around.
Yeah, I heard you the first time you said that.
Listen, Nick. We're gonna do everything we can to solve these missing person cases. When we get any information, we'll let you know.
Why haven't you then? Because I've given you names, and I've given you locations, and I don't understand. How could there be no evidence in Travis's house?
It's not even Travis's house. That's one of your problems.
Whose is it then?
Unfortunately, that information is withheld. It's an open case. I can't share that with you.
Not the general public. I was involved.
Yes, but no legal action was taken on your part, which was a smart decision considering the lack of credible evidence.
Of course it's credible. If you guys ain't gonna do anything on this, I just go higher.
Yeah, well, I suggest you go ahead and do so.
Who owns the 2 houses?
Didn't you hear me the first time?
Yes, I heard you the first time. I have to know.
Listen, Nick, why don't you let us do our job and you go live your life?
Bullshit! This is my life now!
You keep talking to me that way, I'm gonna ask you to leave.
I'll leave when you figure something out.
I figured something out. This is all down on paper, by the way. We pulled your car from a wreck out in the middle of nowhere.
It wasn't a wreck.
You fell asleep at the wheel, you took out a power line, and then you called us the next day.
I wasn't even close to hitting that pole. You people keep saying that.
Now, the report says there's no form of intoxication.
It wasn't a report. That's what I'm saying. You people are doing nothing right. Officer shows up, asks if I was okay, tows my car, and just lets me go.
What the report might have said was that you were driving under the influence of an illegal substance. You know what happens when you drive with an illegal substance in your blood? We don't like a lot of commotion around here. So if you decide to make some commotion, we're gonna, of course, keep an eye out for the harmonious nature of the community.
Yeah, okay. I understand. Maybe cops should just do your job.
Maybe you need to go clear your head.
Yeah, because the smell of bacon's kind of getting to me.
Look, Nick.
No, Steph, don't. You don't have to say anything. I'm only gonna say a couple of things. I know what happened. So do you. And if you want to drop it, it's fine. But I won't.
they think, he thinks that I'm gonna forget. He's wrong. I promise you. I'm sorry for what I've done. Getting you into this. We're gonna find Danny. We're gonna make things right. That's all that can be said.
It's done.
Yes.
Interesting. So, we think tonight I'll go as planned?
How else would it go?
It could go the wrong way.
Yeah, but the wrong way is experience, right?
Sure. And with the experience of last time, it should allow tonight to go smoothly. There'd be no one else to help, no more games, there'd be no more problems, correct?
Of course.
Travis, I'm in this for the business. You're in it for something different. Whether it's for the experience or something else, I don't know. But what I do know is that you're still here. As long as I get what I want, you can stay.
I understand the risk you've gone through to have me here. And if I'm not showing the appreciation that you deserve, I'm sorry.
Well then, I say we get this thing started.